Hey, this is Andrew with ImageQuix, and today I'm going to show you how to create your first My Design template in Blueprint. But before we begin, you'll want to make sure that you have your layout flattened beforehand in a JPEG or PNG format. Also, if you're going to use your layout as a foreground layer, you'll want to make sure that you have the appropriate space cut out for the image node to appear. And with that, let's get started. From the welcome dashboard, we're going to click on My Designs, then we're going to click on the green Add Product button, and we're going to add a print product. Over on the right-hand side, we'll be able to edit this newly created product by giving it a meaningful name, as well as editing the canvas size, such as the width and height. Once we have those values in, we can go ahead and click on the Design button in the top right-hand corner to start designing the product. Now I'm going to add in a foreground layer, so I'm going to click on that green plus button to add in that layer, and then I'm going to click on Choose Image to bring in the layer that I've created outside of Blueprint. Perfect, so now that I've got my beautiful layer in here, I'm going to click on the green Images button there to add in an image node. As you can see here, I'm dragging and dropping to manipulate that image node into the knocked out space that I previously created inside of my design. Over on the right hand side, I have the ability to edit the title of the image node, which helps me understand what this image node is when looking at the layers on the left hand side. I can also automatically size that image node to some popular sizings, as well as put in a more specific width and height. You can use the image mapping field to auto assign an image node to pull the subject's primary image, yearbook image, group image, or any other from the options listed. Now, because we're creating a collage, we're going to need to create two more image nodes. So I'm going to go ahead and create those nodes, drop them into their position inside of the design, and apply those customized functions. Now that I have my three image nodes on my design, I'm going to add in a text layer as well. So I'm going to click on that green plus button to drop in a text node and position it onto the design of where I want it to appear. And I'm going to give this a meaningful name so that at a glance I can see what this text node is doing inside of the design. And as I scroll down, there are different customization options as well, such as the text font. I'm going to go ahead and show that this is powered by Google Fonts, so there's tons of different customization options available. And I'm also going to scale the text to fill that node so that no matter how big or short the name is, it's always going to appear beautifully in the design. And then down at the bottom here, we have our text content. I'm going to set that to subject data. And then I can pick from any of our available subject data fields to dynamically bring in any subject data when the design is ordered. I'm gonna go ahead and set for that to be first name and last name. And then I can check that box to allow customer editing when they're purchasing the design online. And with that, I'm gonna go ahead and sync to save my changes to the cloud.